We are in St. Paul, Minnesota, at the Hmong Elders Center. There is a real sense of family, community. I decided to sort of recreate a modern day studio portraiture that one might see in Laos. Looking at the history of portraiture within the Hmong community, a lot of it is this painted backdrop. So it's the moundscape, it's the floral, the opium flower conjures up this memory in Hmong people's history when they were very prosperous. Hearing these ladies and these men talk about their own history was so transformative, and in a way, it's so different from what I had imagined it to be. But I think maybe because they are really hard to listen to, and they're really hard for us to, even as a Hmong American, as a daughter who has parents who's had to flee the war, it's really hard for me to grasp or understand how a five-year-old can start fighting in a war that he didn't cause or that he didn't make. Or how a mother can carry 11 children through the jungles of Laos, cross the Mekong River, and make life in the refugee camps before coming to the United States. Really listening to them talk about the hardships that they've had, how old they were when they fought in the war, how old they were when they were married, or how many kids they've lost. It's always like really surprising when people are so open about themselves, their history. They're like literally pouring their hearts out to us. And thinking about this history, how we inherit this history, how we talk about this history, how we think about this history, has been really life-changing for me.